This is the Ender 3 Pro, and you can see it's had a bit of rough handling, but the packaging material inside these boxes is very good, and everything was received in perfect condition. If you've seen Creeldy's packaging before, it's quite good. Everything is very well protected with these cutout foam panels. The problem I had with the Ender 3, when you move this back and forth, there were flat spots on the wheels. They were too tight. This has been shipped with the wheels loose, so there will be no flat spots on there, but you do need to adjust that. I'm going to go around the Ender 3 Pro and see what the differences are between it and the Ender 3. First thing you see is the magnetic print surface. That has worked real well and makes it real easy to release prints. The carriage under the hotbed now has four wheels, and they are centered on the carriage, as they should be, and they're running on a 40-40 extrusion. This was shipped loose, and I've adjusted it, and it has sat overnight. There's no clunking noticeable on that whatsoever. The next thing is that the fan has been moved to the bottom of the box for the motherboard. You no longer have the possibility of having things drop through the fan, like with the Ender 3. And when you turn it on, it says Ender 3 Pro. The power supply is thinner than the one on the Ender 3, and it has an automatic fan control. That fan only runs when it needs to, so it does tend to cut down on some of the noise. I have chosen to use the cable chains. I've got them on the Ender 3. The Ender 3 has 450 hours on it, and these have worked perfectly on the Ender 3. I think it makes it nice because you can pick this unit up and move it where you want to, and when you set it down, the cables are in exactly the same position they were before. The angle plate that holds the extruder is now correctly bent at 90 degrees in both directions, and the alignment of the Z-axis lead screw with the Z-stepper is not a problem. The only thing I did, I put a 1 millimeter shim behind the plastic mount for the Z-stepper. So this goes up and down very smoothly, all the way to the top and to the bottom. I have found that this ball bearing filament guide works very well, and it keeps the filament from rubbing on the lead screw. There's still some sharp edges where they've milled the notch in this piece of 40-40 for the cables to exit from the motherboard box. You still need to print a plastic insert to go in there to keep these wires from rubbing against the sharp edge. That's easy to do, and the file is available from Thingiverse. I've used a number of different cable clips for wire management, just like I did on the Ender 3. The Y-axis end stop is now mounted on a couple of T-nuts, so it's very easy to move that back and forth to zero the hotbed at the home position. And you no longer have to print a different mounting plate for that. I'm using the original fans that came with the Ender 3 Pro, and like I did on the Ender 3, I put in the bullseye base and the bullseye pipe. I have over 450 hours on the Ender 3, and this has worked real well. And then I have a video that shows putting these guards across the front of the fan so you don't accidentally stick something into a running fan. This timing belt needs to ride low in this groove on this 2020 extrusion, if for no other reason than the wheels from the hot end carriage are going back and forth on top of it. The plate that bolts on here, I don't know if this is punched off center on purpose or not, but you can see that this is quite a bit above the line going through these two mounting holes. And on the Ender 3 and on this one, that was high and was holding the belt high. So on both of these, I've turned this plate over, put it back together again, which drops this turnaround pulley and lowers that timing belt in the groove. And now this is riding in about the same elevation as the belt is over on the X stepper motor. Still need to print a cover for the back of the control panel. And again, that's easy to do. I like the extruder flag. It gives you a visual reference of when the extruder is extruding and when it's retracting and how fast. And this clip that goes on the corner of the extruder holds on to the hot end wires. Plus, I've got one more zip tie that keeps this in position, which aligns the cable chain. The files for all of these things will be listed at the bottom of the description for this video. Once again, I'm using the filament spool ball bearing support. It takes a full-size spool of filament. I'm using my spacer. This keeps these two bearings from getting too close together. I've cut the flange off of this one so it would go over here further. Like the Ender 3, this is a 24-volt system. The hot end and the hot bed heat up very quick, and the stepper motors run quite cool on this, especially compared to the temperatures that I've experienced on the CR10. The file for this bolt and nut came with the CR10. The print has just completed, and you pick up the plate and you can take these right off. This is the best test you can do for a printer. You can take this right off the bed, and straight away that screws together. This unit went together very well. No real issues. The only things that I think need to be done are the wire protector for the wires coming out of the box for the motherboard and to put a cover on the back of the control panel. This prints well and it's quiet compared to other printers. These are on sale. They've got the price down to where these are very reasonable, I think. If you're looking for a Christmas present for yourself, this would be a good place to start. The link and the discount codes will be in the video description.